Good morning, students. The next topic we are going to see is the vehicle which is on a leveled circular road. So this we have seen already actually. So any vehicle which is moving on the leveled circular road, it has the centripetal force. And as we know that when it is moving in the circular path between the tire and the road, there is what? There is a frictional force, and that frictional force gives you your centripetal force, is it not? Here consider a vehicle which is having the mass m and it is moving at the speed v and the radius to be r. They are saying that there are three forces which is acting on the vehicle. So when this is moving in the circular path, there are three forces. What are the forces? Is first one the gravitational force, as we know, and that is given by mg, and it is acting downwards, and the normal force which is acting upwards, yes. And next one is the frictional force. That frictional force is given by F of s, and that frictional force, it acts inwards. Okay, so these are the three forces. Now so this is an object which is moving in the straight road. As we know, when this is moving in the straight road, when you consider this to be the object, upward there is a force and downward there is a force. Upward is said to be the normal force, and downward we have the gravitational force which is given by m into g. So that is what is given here. When it is moving in the straight road, it has the two forces. Same way, when it is moving in the circular path, it has three forces. So this is the object which you are considering. This has upward force which is normal force, downward it has a gravitational force which is given by mg. Since it is moving in the circular path, it has an additional force which is given by the frictional force which is F of s. Okay, so there are three forces: normal, gravitational, and also the frictional force. Now we are going to take the formula for frictional force. As we know that this both can be equated, n is equal to m into g, is it not? And same way we are going to also take the formula for frictional force. That frictional force is equal to what? Mu s into n. So this will be the frictional force which you will be taking, is it not? So when you take with the force here, first this F of s, we are equating it for the centripetal force. Centripetal force formula is mv square by r. So F of s is equal to mv square divided by r. As we know from the frictional force, F of s is equal to what? F of s is equal to mu s into n. From the diagram, we get n is equal to what? From the diagram, we are writing n is equal to m into g. So how we are writing? Because this is in the upward direction, this is in the downward direction. So both are acting along the y-axis. So we are writing as n is equal to m into g. Now this m into g, if you write it here, we get mu s into m into g. Okay, so the condition is by F of s which is less than or equal to. So why we are writing as less than or equal to is because always the frictional force is lesser. Okay, so we are writing it as less than or equal to mu s m into g. So both we have it as frictional force, that is F of s, is not? So idu F of s na, idu F of s da. So appa enna pannalam, idu rendi equate pannalam. Okay, so we can write this as mv square by r which is less than mu s m g. So there are two conditions possible. So we are going to have it as two conditions. So what are the two condition? Is first is less than or equal to, second condition is greater than. Okay, first when it is less than or equal to, okay, now both the sides we can cancel with the term m. Yes, now bring this g down, so we get mu of s in the side eldum bodhu enna eluvom greater than. So greater than or equal to v square divided by in the r appadi irukum g mattum kila kondirukom. So v square divided by rg. Okay, now this can also be written as mu s in the rg in the side kondu padana mu s into rg which is greater than or equal to v square nadalama. Okay, now bring this square this side. So when you bring square this side, that becomes as root of, so root of mu s rg which is greater than v. Okay, so this gives a formula for the first condition where this is less than or equal to. So we have the second condition now. So before going on to the second condition, we are going to write what it is. Okay, we can say that this to be like greater than, so the coefficient of static friction determines maximum speed. So here the coefficient of static friction only determines the maximum speed what it has to move. Okay, then we have the second condition here, which is greater than, so m v square by r, which is greater than mu s m g. Same way here also cancel with the term m, bring this g down. Okay, so we get mu s is less than v square by rg. Whenever this coefficient of friction is less than this term, there is a condition for skidding. So static friction is not able to provide necessary centripetal force. So centripetal force illandradanala what happens, the vehicle will start to skid. So inga centripetal force inga edanala nu sonom, because of the frictional force between what, tire and the road. So and the டயருக்கும் ரோடுக்கும் நல்ல ஃப்ரிக்ஷனல் ஃபோர்ஸ் இல்லை அப்படின்னால என்னாகும், திஸ் வெஹிக்கிள் வில் ஸ்டார்ட் டு ஸ்கிட். ஸோ வெஹிக்கிள் வந்து ஸ்கிட் ஆயிரும். ஸோ திஸ் கிவ்ஸ் அ கண்டிஷன் ஃபார் ஸ்கிட்டிங். ஃபார் எனி வெஹிக்கிள் டு ஸ்கிட், திஸ் இஸ் அ நெசசரி கண்டிஷன் விச் இஸ் கிவன் பை மியூ ஸ்கொயர், விச் இஸ் லெஸ் தேன் வி ஸ்கொயர் பை ஆர்ஷி. எஸ், கிளியர் திஸ்? தேங்க்யூ.